So this year I've been doing the 100 day project, and I've been painting every day in my sketchbook using a range of mediums such as gouache, coloured pencils and Posca pens. I've had a few people ask me how I would digitise these artworks and turn them into patterns. So today I thought I would show you exactly how you could do that. Hello, I'm Mel Armstrong. I'm an illustrator and surface pattern designer from Wellington, New Zealand. Let's get into it. So the first thing that I need to do is scan my artwork into the computer. I use an Epson ET3700 to scan, but you could use your phone camera, just as long as you have really good light and no shadows on your artwork. Once it's scanned in, I open it up in Photoshop and use the crop tool to just crop out the edges of the sketchbook. I'm not concerned about cutting parts off my painting because I probably won't use them anyway in the final pattern. Now let's see what happens when I turn on the pattern preview. As you can see, this is not a great pattern. It doesn't repeat and just looks weird. So we do need to do a bit of manipulation to get this to repeat seamlessly. So first off, let's create another file. This is going to be my pattern file, and I'm going to make that 3000 by 3000 pixels, 300 dpi. And I'm going to cut out the elements I need from my original painting. I'm going to pull them into this file to create the repeating pattern. So just going to sample the background color here and put it into my pattern file. So back in my original file, I'm going to remove the background layer. And to do that, I use the magic wand tool. You may need to adjust the tolerance just to ensure it grabs most of it. I have mine set to about 50, which should work fine. Now there are a few patches here that I haven't been able to select with the one click. So all I need to do is hold down my shift key and click where I need to add them. And then once I'm happy with the selection, I'm going to go and inverse it. And then I'm going to click on the add vector mask tool icon. And that just removes the background. I can now just apply that layer mask. And now I'm going to use my lasso tool to cut out the elements. And I'm going to start with this flower here. And I'm just going to use Command C or Control C on a PC to copy, and then Command V or Control V to paste into my pattern file. And I'm going to repeat that for all the elements that I want. I'm now going to convert each of my motifs into smart objects, and the reason I do this is that if I want to copy them and then I make changes to one, it will apply to all the copies of that one element, and it also allows me to resize them without losing any quality. I'm going to jump into a few of these and just tidy them up a bit. There's a little bit of speckles of paint that I want to delete, and maybe clean up some of the edges. But I'm not going to do too much because I just want to keep the painterly look that I created on paper. And now it's time to create our pattern, and I'm going to use the pattern preview tool to do this. And the benefit of using this is that it will show me the repeating pattern as I create it. So I'm just going to duplicate each element and move them around until I'm completely happy with my repeating pattern. And I've decided that I really want to use a painted background. So I've actually gone and painted another background for this. And I'm going to bring this into Photoshop and create a pattern from it. So I've scanned in my background and I've put it into a 3000 by 3000 pixel square canvas. And I'm going to create a repeating pattern from it. Now, there's a few little marks here, so I'm just using the spot healing brush to just clean up a few spots. And I also like to use the clone tool to do this as well. Now, once I'm happy with that, we have to offset it to create a repeating textured background. So to do that, I go to Filter, Other, and then Offset. And make sure that half the horizontal and half the vertical, so it's 1500 by 1500, so that's half the size of the canvas. And that will put a line down the middle and a line across. I like to use the clone tool and the spot healing brush tool to merge these lines so that they aren't so popping out at you. The idea here is to make it look seamless, and so we just need to clean that up. And once I'm happy with that, I'm going to go to Edit, Define Pattern and create a pattern. Then I'm going to go back to my original and add that to the bottom as my background layer. So I'm going to go to Layer, New Fill Layer, Pattern Layer, and then select the textured background. And it's the same size as our pattern here, so I don't need to adjust that at all. And there you have a repeating pattern tile originated from my painting in my sketchbook. Now, this isn't the usual way I would do this, mind you. I would actually paint all the elements separate and then bring them in to create the pattern. This is just a workaround for if you've painted in your sketchbook with a background, and you need to be able to cut them out to create a repeating pattern in Photoshop. And another thing you can do now is you could export that as a JPEG, and I would sometimes upload that to Spoonflower, and then you can have it printed onto fabric. And that's just a great little way of making a passive income from your repeat pattern files. And I have a video on that if you want to find out more. And that is it. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time.